Welcome back to Dogami World. This video is entirely about the breeding changes that are coming to Dogami. I'm not going to share with you that the final breed of the second series is the Australian Shepherd, or that Dogami has a partnership now with Gap, and you'll have the opportunity to get a hoodie for your Dogami real soon. Now that I've not shared that with you, in my first video we talked about the white paper and the rules related to breeding your Dogami, but apparently that has all changed. Now I'll say, we haven't received an official word from the Dogami team about what I'm about to cover, but there is a high probability that this is accurate. First, for the breeding information that we already knew about just in case you were new to Dogami. Number one, a Dogami can only breed during specific periods called love seasons, and this has to be in the adult phase. Next, every Dogami has a limited breed count, meaning they can only mate a limited number of times during their life. But how many that is, we don't know. Number three, Generation Alpha Dogami will have a larger breed count. And finally, for simplicity, at the early stages of the game, only Dogami from the same breed will be able to mate. However, popular mixed breeds are in development and will be released as the game progresses. Now this says popular mixed breeds, so don't expect your future Chihuahua to start climbing up the leg of my Great Dane. In fact, I don't think anything should breed with a Chihuahua. They're like mosquitoes. If they were extinct, I'm not sure anyone would care. Okay, now that I've offended all of you Chihuahua lovers, on to the new breeding news. Dogami cannot breed with any of their family members. No incest. This includes the parents, siblings, or even half-siblings. But I do suspect we will see kissing cousins as acceptable breeding partners. Let me know in the comments if you can name these famous kissing cousin couples. Number two. Every consecutive breed increases the cooldown for the next chance at breeding. For example, you might have to skip a love season after your first breeding and maybe skip two love seasons after your second breeding and maybe three after your third breeding. Now let's talk about where this gets really interesting and very different from what we've known before. Apparently there is going to be the love garden. Okay, let's just call it what it is. This is a brothel where the females are looking for that handsome stud to give them a beautiful gift. And here's how it works. If you have a male, you can rent a cheap hotel room for that Dogami, and if a female thinks you are worth it, she'll pay you a nice sum of doga to hang out in your room for the evening. Then when she's done with you, she'll leave with a special package in tow, and you will need to pay half of your earnings to the boss of the brothel. So basically, the male gets half the breeding fee, and the female gets a new puppy box, which I assume can be opened or remain closed. If it can remain closed, that will be a very interesting sell on the Dogami marketplace. I'm not sure how that would work and how you would know what box belongs to which parents for determining the possible value of the Dogami. Now, if you own your own pair of compatible male and female Dogami, you do not have to use the love garden, the brothel. You can use what is called the owner's kennel. Since the siring fee is waived, there will be a reduced fee for breeding, so maybe you just have to pay 50% of the breeding fee to Dogami. So here are a couple more important items to know about breeding. The breeding fee is going to be based on the rarity tier combination. So if you have two diamonds breeding, the fee is going to be higher than if you have two bronzes breeding. Also, it's important to know that with each consecutive breeding, the cost will get higher to breed. Another thing to note is the same pair of Dogami can mate more than once. It doesn't say more than twice though, so I'm not sure how many times or if they can mate all the way to the spirit phase. We also know from before that the Dogami's offspring's characteristics will be determined by a genetic algorithm technique that crosses the parent's DNA. The algorithm will also use mutation techniques to randomize the outcome of the pairing, but we'll get more details about the breeding and genetic algorithm as the game progresses. Finally, the love seasons represent the only period in which Dogami are fertile and can breed. Love seasons are a measure to control the population of the petiverse, and every love season will have varying parameters that define breeding costs, breeding counts, and cooldown periods. This mechanism will serve as a tool for population management and implementing new or limited edition breeding recipes. We'll just have to wait and see what that's all about. If this was of interest to you, give the video a like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.